We've got Robbie from Arsenal Fan TV. Robbie, how are you doing? Are you on the phone lines there?
Yeah, not too bad. Just been enjoying watching Manchester City put in an even worse defensive performance last night.
Well, they're obviously having fan and players sent off right, left and centre as well. And apparently Chelsea have just missed a penalty. So I guess that's putting smiles on yours and Kenny's faces quite a lot at the moment. So let's talk about yesterday's game then. Obviously, I mean, we've got strong opinions here. Kenny's got strong opinions about it. It was fairly disastrous. Obviously, they're a tactical nightmare. Why do you think this is, and where is it going for Arsenal? How can they get themselves out of basically this total mess?
It was just, it's horrible last night because, you know, it was they'd done everything right from the beginning. They'd, free up. It should be game over. And basically, it's something that we've seen a lot from Arsenal over the years, in that we, instead of sometimes just shutting a game down and, you know, just locking up shop, we're going to try and score like 4, 5, 6, 7 and everybody's bombing forward and forgetting about the defensive side of the game, which is just as important. I mean, I've been watching this Manchester City game tonight. It looks like they're trying to outdo us the way they're defending. But, I mean, defence is just as important as attack. And I know we've got a lot of injuries in that, but I just felt the team performance defensively last night was very, very poor. And we got punished for it. We got away with it over there in Anderlecht, but last night we got punished for it. And, I mean, we didn't lose, remember. It was a draw, but it did feel a bit like a defeat. Because, you know, 3-0 up, it should have been game, set and match.
So, obviously, we're talking a lot about defence, January transfer window opening. What do you see the solution?
Well, you know, definitely we need to, something that we know, we need to buy a top quality, top class holding midfielder.
And in your eyes, who would that be?
We should have bought... Well, I thought in the summer we should have bought Sami Khedira, although he has been injured, to be fair, you know, and hasn't really played this season. But I thought Sami Khedira would have been perfect. You know, he's a workhorse, and I think he would have been able to have done a job in there in the middle of the park for us. And we should have bought another defender, and I think it was, you know... And I'm a fan of Arsene Wenger, but I think there's no doubt that he's made massive errors in not filling those two positions, and it's left us short.
Robbie, it's Peter here. Before you get to Kenny, the Arsenal fan, I just wanted to ask you. Do you think? I mean, apart from beating Burnley at home, which anyone can do, even you know, even a team in the Championship
at
home could beat Burnley. Yeah, even QPR could.
You haven't played them yet, have you?
Well, how many Arsenal defenders could get in the QPR team?
Back to your question, Peter.
How many Arsenal defenders could get in the QPR defence?
How many QPR forwards could get in the Arsenal
But anyway,
team?
Robbie, I want to ask you, do you think sometimes the crowd, because you've got such a big stadium, can get to the players a little bit? Because your best performances have been away from home, where you go to Sunderland, you win convincingly, you've been to other grounds, and then at home you've struggled against Palace, you've struggled against Hull, you had Anderlecht as well. Do you think sometimes it's the crowd sort of can get to the Arsenal players a little bit?
I don't think it's the crowd. No, I don't think the crowd has got to them. I just think that, you know, all season they haven't really, in any game really, been, you know, I think apart from the game against Aston Villa away, I thought we played really well that day, but I don't think in any game we've really hit the heights of what we can really achieve. Home and away. So I just think that there is a lot more to come. There has been a lot of mitigating circumstances.
But is it fair to say, Robbie, last season you led the league for the majority of it. This season you've struggled. I mean, do you really see yourselves finishing above Southampton?
I do see us finishing above Southampton. It's still early in the season. We got to remember, we're just in November. We've only just hit November. And even though we haven't been playing well, we are still, you know, in the top four. So it's not all doom and gloom, but the performances haven't been the best,
Robbie,
by Arsenal. We haven't performed well, and we do need to step up.
Now, Robbie, as you interview fans after the game, obviously the fans booed the Arsenal players off. What was the general atmosphere? Is there still, because you're still talking fairly positively. I'll let you talk to Kenny in a minute, fan to fan. But just, you know, the general consensus as Arsenal fans, what is it?
the general consensus of Arsenal fans is a lot of frustration. And I think a lot of that frustration is the fact that a few of the problems that we've got at the moment have been self-inflicted in that we, as I said before, we didn't buy a holding midfielder, and we left ourselves short in defence by not buying a centre-back. And I feel a bit sorry for players like Nacho Monreal, who's a second-choice left-back, having to be our first-choice centre-back at the moment because we're so short because of injuries. But I think that that's a position that we didn't need to be in if we would have signed a centre-back, and we've kind of put ourselves in that position. So there's a lot of frustration from fans in that lots of fans were crying out for us to fill those positions before the season started, and we didn't. And now we're, a lot of fans know that, listen, we've got lots and lots of injuries. There's no getting away from that. There are lots and lots of injuries.
Oh, come on, Robbie.
Lots
of injuries. So have Man United, so have QPR.
Talking of injuries, Robbie, obviously it didn't look much like he missed Ozil out there. Was he a complete waste of money then?
Hold on, sorry, 1 second. I just wanted to ask...
you want to answer Pete?
He said, so are Man United, so are QPR, and where are they? So, injuries do affect you, right? So that's what I'm trying to say. There are a lot of injuries. I don't think we've...
Well, put it this way, Robbie, Man United would do better in the Champions League at the moment than Arsenal are doing.
Yeah, not in the Champions League, Pete.
If they were in it...
They ain't in it though, are they? That's the thing.
You're not in it for very much longer, because you're going to finish second. You're going to be one of the big guns, Barcelona, Real Madrid.
Let's wait and see.
As I said, I try not to just have bad reactions to just one bad performance. As I said, there's a lot of frustration around at the moment from Arsenal fans because, as I said, I think the main source of frustration is those two positions, the holding midfielder position and the centre-back, we should really have covered that. And we didn't, the manager didn't do that. And that is what I think is where the frustration lies.
Certainly seems that way. Now, obviously, Robbie, it's time that you spoke to Kenny and had words as Arsenal fans.
Rob, yeah, there's going to be a loving now.
Rob, we go through this all the time, don't we? Like I said, I've spoken to you face-to-face about our problems. And you've made some really good points about us getting a defensive midfielder and a centre-half. But you've played the game as long as I have, and you've watched Arsenal for a long time. You can have all those players, but if the mentality is not right, it's not going to make a blind bit of difference. You look at Chelsea. Yeah. You look at Oscar when he played against Man United. Now, Oscar's one of the best attacking midfielders in a Premiership. Yet Oscar sacrificed his game for the cause. Now, you look at Flamini, he's a defensive midfielder. Now, he's getting slated because of the collective mistakes. But what people don't seem to realise is that he's doing two or three people's jobs. And the worst thing about it, you can have Khedira.
Is that a question, Craig?
What should I say, Rob? You can have Khedira and you can have your centre-halves. But if the team does not defend as a team, we're still going to have the same problems. And you've got to agree on that, Rob.
I think you make a great point there in that last night, when you look at that equalising goal that they scored, Podolski, he'd only just come on the pitch and he literally made no attempt to stop that ball from coming in. And that's all part of the defending. And you're right. I mean, if you look at, say, Chelsea, one of the reasons why they are so good is because of how they defend as a team. And if you remember last year, everybody was bigging up Eden Hazard and saying how great he was last season. And Mourinho actually turned around and criticised him because he's like, you know what, you're great going forward, but you don't do nothing for the team.
It's the same like Joe Cole when he was doing it.
But ultimately,
he's changed his game. And you look at players like Willian and the effort. By the way, Man City just lost.
That's great news.
He's changed the mentality of the Chelsea players. Defend as a team is much better than ours.
Yeah, but Robbie Kelly, you have got a great manager. He's a longest-serving manager. He's done wonders for the club.
He's a longest-serving manager, but tactically, he's inept. He's not right tactically.
Oh, some of the flying football that you play is fantastic.
You talk about the flying football, but you can lose matches. You can lose matches by not defending as a team.
Right, guys. So let's just look ahead to the weekend and obviously the Swansea game. Robbie, how do you see that one playing out?
Well, listen, we've got to defend better than what we've been defending over the past couple of weeks, especially against Anderlecht. We've got to have... I agree with the gentleman there. Tactically yesterday, it was very poor. We should have shut the game down, and we didn't. I think if we can defend well against Swansea, we've got enough to beat them. You know, Theo Walcott's back now, and that's giving the place a lift.
And do you think he'll play at the
weekend? There are positives there with Arsenal. I mean, we've got Alexis Sanchez right now. To me, probably apart from, say, Aguero, he's the best player in the Premier League. So there are a lot of positive things about Arsenal. The only negative at the moment is that we must defend better as a team. If we can do that, I'm confident that we'll beat Swansea.
Okay, well, fantastic. Robbie, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you very much.
Thanks. Bye.
Thank you, Robbie. Thanks, banter, Rob.
See you later, Rob. See you at the Man United game.
Well, we've got to beat them.
Yeah, make sure we get Adam, get out of Adam McCullough as well.
You can beat Tottenham, man. Well, I don't think you can beat Man United.
I was going to say goodbye to Robbie, but Robbie, if you're still there, what's your score prediction for the weekend?
Score prediction for the weekend, I'm going to go 2-1 to Arsenal.
All right. Thank you, Robbie. We'll let you go there. Thank you so much.
Cheers. Bye.